Could this be the forgotten successor to the legendary Logitech C920 and C922 webcams? Let's find out. Now, the camera in question is the Logitech C925E. So, like the C920, it maxes out at 1080p with 30 frames per second. Both actually share the same 78 degree field of view, and both have integrated microphones in them. And at the bottom, a quarter 20 mount that you can use to mount it to a tripod. Both have a 2 meter long cable, and the specs it says 1.83 meters, but it's taller than me and I'm 6'4", so trust me when I say it is a 2 meter cable that you have terminating with USB-A. And they both work with the Logitune desktop app to be able to dial in the image on PC or Mac. The Logitech C925E, however, is certified for Microsoft Teams because it's a bit newer. It came out more or less the same time that Microsoft Teams was released in 2016. It has a built-in privacy shutter, as you can see here. And it's also about 126 millimeters wide, or about 5 inches, compared to the C920's narrower 94 millimeter width. You can compare the two here. And it released about 4 years later than the C920 in 2016, like I mentioned before, whereas the C920 actually coincided with the predicted end of the world in 2012. But let's see if they're more or less the same camera, because my suspicion is they've basically reskinned the internals of what's in the C920 and put them in the C925E. So let's try that out and see if they're any different. Okay, so you're hearing and also seeing the default camera settings on the Logitech, the C925E right now. And I'm gonna bring in the Logitech C920 for a side-by-side view. And now I'm switching the microphone over to its default microphone on the Logitech C920, just to be able to compare the two. Again, this one is also with completely default settings, nothing set for either camera in Logitune or in OBS. Now let's see if we can tweak the image a little bit using Logitune. When I come back, I'm gonna try to set them both up identically because they look pretty darn close to one another. All right, so coming back to these two cameras, these are the tuned images. I didn't tweak a lot because I didn't want to radically kind of change the way it looked from Logitune. So for both cameras, both the C920 as well as the C925E, I took the brightness down to 116 and I brought the sharpness up to 140. Now what the sharpness bringing up does is it kind of introduces a little bit of background noise, which hopefully gets kind of filtered out a little bit in the, under the compression with YouTube, but I thought it kind of cleared up, you know, from a focus almost perspective, the crispness of the image a little bit, given that both of these cameras have pretty small sensors. So now I'm going to actually add a little bit of OBS additional settings to each of them just to see what I can do there in addition to what we just did in Logitune. So this is the Logitech C925E first, and all I did in OBS was I set the gamma down to -0.11. I took the contrast down to -0.09. I set the brightness and left it at zero, so it's all zeroed out. I took saturation down just a little bit to try to get my lights in the background, which don't show up as purple in real life. So I took saturation down to -0.18. And again, to kind of correct those lights a little bit, I brought the hue up just a tiny bit to 1.54 in the positive side. Everything else is the same, didn't touch the microphone or any audio filters. This is just the Logitech C925E. Okay, so this is the Logitech C920. I've got exactly the same settings on this camera because I have a feeling they're the same sensors and more or less the same hardware firmware. Again, this is everything from the Logitech C920. Okay, so this was a little bit tricky in terms of the two cameras, the C925E and the C920. I thought they'd be the same, more or less with the same size sensor, the same field of view, you know, the same USB-A termination, same software, same everything. But once I put them on the timeline, I could see the subtle differences between the two of them. I'd have to say, one, the microphone on the C925E, I was recording both microphones the entire time. I pretty much switched everything over to the C925E's microphone for most of the timeline. You'll see that in the lower thirds also as each of the cameras are playing. It was way better. So that is an advantage of the C925E. On a funnier side, I guess the C920, to me at least, from the shape of my face, from the optics perspective, I'm a bit rounder in terms of my face. I gotta say, the C920 was a bit more flattering, at least for me. And also, I liked its default skin tones not being quite as pink as the C925E. So, would I choose one versus the other? Well, I would say if you're like a Teams user and you don't always turn on your camera, but you need a good microphone and you're not gonna buy an external microphone, the C925E is probably the one I would pick because it is Teams certified and the microphone in it is really good. If I was a streamer and had a separate microphone and just wanted to look my best, I would pick the C920. It's also about $10-ish dollars cheaper than the C925E. So I do think, at least in my case, because I'd probably always use an external mic, I would probably pick the C920. But if you just want one device and you don't want to use the camera in your laptop or the one that maybe came with your monitor or you don't have one on your monitor, I would use the C925E, and both of them are pretty good. They both have the same tuning, the same the same application to use with the Logitune app. All of that's more or less identical between the two cameras. So both are going to be good choices, but for me, the C920 wins a little bit, with the exception of the microphone. So if you like this review, you got value from it, be sure to give me a like and subscribe to my channel for more work from home and hardware tips, and I'll see you in the next one.